When doing computations, there's a specific order of operations. The first step is parentheses. If there are any operations in parentheses, those computations should be performed first. Step 2, exponents and roots. Simplify any numbers being raised to a power and any numbers under the radical symbols. Step 3, multiplication and division. Do these two operations in order in which they appear, working from left to right. Step 4, addition and subtraction. Do these two operations in order in which they appear, working from left to right. To help us remember this, we can remember the sentence, "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally." The P in please will help us to remember parentheses come first. The E in excuse will help us to remember two exponents next. This also includes roots. My dear will help us to remember multiplication and division are working from left to right. Aunt Sally will help us to remember addition and subtraction, and those operations we will work from left to right. We will evaluate this expression 2 to the third plus 30 divided by 5. We will follow our order of operations. First, we will do parentheses. In this problem, there aren't any parentheses, so we will skip that. Next, we will do our exponents and roots. In this problem, we have one exponent part of this expression. We will compute 2 to the third. 2 to the third is equal to 2 times 2 times 2. 2 to the third is equal to 8. With every step, we will write the problem, making one little change. We changed the 2 to the third to what it is equal to. And we write everything else in the problem down, making sure that every line is equal to the previous line. So we've completed our exponents and roots step. Next, we will do multiplication and division from left to right. Here we will look at 30 divided by 5. 30 divided by 5 is equal to 6. And we will write the rest of the problem. We have finished our multiplication and division step, so we will do our addition and subtraction step. 8 plus 6 is equal to 14. As you work down, you will see that each line of this problem is equal to the previous line. Our next problem is 7 minus 4 minus the product 8 times 3. We will start with our parentheses. 8 times 3 is equal to 24. We will write the rest of the problem down and then go on to our next step, exponents and roots. We do not have any exponents and roots in this problem, so we'll go down to multiplication and division. We do not have any multiplication and division, so we will go to the next step, addition and subtraction from left to right. We will start with 7 minus 4. 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. And we will write the rest of the problem down. Now we will compute 3 minus 24. Let's change this to an addition problem by adding the opposite of 24, which is negative 24. So 3 plus negative 24, the signs are different, so we will subtract the numbers and get 21, and we will keep the sign of the dominant number. So our answer to this problem is negative 21. We will evaluate 45 divided by 5 times negative 3 plus the square root of 25. We will start by doing any operations inside parentheses. The only parentheses we have are right here, and this is a negative 3. There is nothing to calculate in the parentheses, so we don't have anything to do in this step. So we will go to our exponents and roots step. Here is our one exponent and root. The square root of 25 is equal to 5. We ask ourselves what squared gives us 25. So the square root of 25 is 5. And we will write down the rest of the problem before moving on to the next step. Now we will do multiplication and division working from left to right. So we will actually do this division part of the problem first because it is what appears first as we move from left to right. 45 divided by 5 is equal to 9. We will write the rest of the problem down before moving on. Now we will continue to do the multiplication and division step by multiplying 9 times negative 3. 9 times 3 is equal to 27. We have two numbers with different signs, so when you multiply two numbers with different signs, the product is negative. So we have completed our multiplication and division step, and we will move on to our addition and subtraction step. We have negative 27 plus 5. We are adding two integers whose signs are different. So we will subtract the absolute values of the two numbers. 27 minus 5 is equal to 22. And we will keep the sign of the dominant number. The dominant number is 27, and 27 is negative, so our answer is negative. Evaluate negative 5 squared minus the quantity 5 minus 12 times negative 3. We will start by doing what is inside the parentheses first. Notice, inside the parentheses we have a subtraction problem. So we will rewrite this as an addition problem. So we add the opposite of 12. So what is 5 plus negative 12? 5 plus negative 12, the signs are different, so we will subtract the absolute values of the numbers and get 7. And we will keep the sign of the dominant number. And then we will write down the rest of the problem. There is nothing left to compute inside these parentheses. And there's nothing left to compute inside these parentheses. So now we will move on to our exponents and roots. Here is our exponent and root part of this problem. We see this as negative 5 squared. The square is only affecting the 5. So this could be written as 5 times 5 with the negative out in front. Every time we make a little change, we write the rest of the problem down. So now we can compute 5 times 5, which is equal to 25, and we will bring the negative in front. So we have now completed our exponents and roots step. Next, we will do multiplication and division. Here is our multiplication part of this problem. Negative 7 times negative 3. Negative 7 times negative 3, the signs are the same, so the product will be positive. 7 times 3 is 21, and we get a positive 21. We need to bring down our subtraction sign and the rest of the problem. We have finished our multiplication and division step, so we will move on to our addition and subtraction step. Negative 25 minus 21. We will change this problem to an addition problem by adding the opposite. We are adding negative 25 plus negative 21. The signs are the same, so we will add the numbers together and keep the sign. 25 plus 21 is 46, and we will keep the sign negative. So our answer is negative 46. Evaluate the square root of 16 minus the quantity 8 minus 5 plus 3 squared divided by negative 3 times 2. We will start with parentheses. These are the parentheses that we need to compute. 8 minus 5 plus 3 squared. We need to do our exponents first inside parentheses. 3 squared is equal to 9, because 3 times 3 is 9. We make one little change and we write the rest of the problem down. Next, we will do multiplication and division inside of the parentheses, but there is no multiplication and division, so we will skip to addition and subtraction. 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. Again, we're making just one little change and writing the rest of the problem down. Every line of the problem will equal the previous line. Finally, we get 3 plus 9, which is equal to 12. We've done all the computations that are inside parentheses, so we'll move on to exponents and roots. The exponent and root that we need to calculate in this problem is the square root of 16. The square root of 16 asks us the question, what squared equals 16? 4 squared equals 16, so the square root of 16 is 4. And again, we're writing the problem down, making one little change. We finished our exponents and roots step, and we'll move on to multiplication and division, working from left to right. Here is our multiplication and division that we need to compute at this time. We will start from left to right. We'll do 12 divided by negative 3 first. 12 divided by negative 3, the signs are different, so the quotient will be negative. 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4, and because the signs are different, our quotient is negative. Next, we will do our multiplication. Negative 4 times 2. Negative 4 times 2, the signs are different, so our product will be negative. 4 times 2 is equal to 8, so we have a negative 8. We finished our multiplication and division step, and now we'll go and do addition and subtraction. We have a subtraction, so we need to change it to addition by adding the opposite. The opposite of negative 8 is positive 8. So we get 4 plus 8, which is equal to 12. Our next problem is 5 plus the absolute value of the quantity 3 minus 6. We will start with parentheses. The absolute value symbols in this problem are the same as parentheses. They are a way of grouping parts of this expression together, and they act just like parentheses. So we will do our absolute value part first. So let's change the subtraction 3 minus 6 to an addition problem by adding the opposite. The signs are different, so we will take the difference of the absolute values of the two numbers, 6 minus 3 is 3, and we will keep the sign of the dominant number. The dominant number is 6, and 6 is negative, so our answer is negative. What is the absolute value of negative 3? The absolute value of any number is a positive, so the absolute value of negative 3 is positive 3. So we have finished our parentheses. We don't have any exponents. We don't have any multiplication and division, so now we're ready to add and subtract. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So the answer to this problem is 8.